Friends, I welcome all of you once again to the revision session part 2. So, as you know that we had learned the objective paper pattern, we had discussed certain things. Let's revise once again the topic which we had started, the natural resources, air, water and land, very quickly. Okay, so in the last session we had discussed the little bit part of that topic. Now let's discuss further. So as you know that students, in the atmosphere, we spoke about there are basically three spheres which are present around the earth. So can you recall what are the three spheres which are present around the earth? Yeah, there are basically three spheres which are present around the earth: atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere. Atmosphere, it is a part of the air which is present around the earth. Lithosphere, it is a part of the land which is occupied on the earth. Hydrosphere, it is a part of the water which is occupied on the earth. So there are basically, you can see that the three spheres which are present on the earth. Out of three spheres, if you observe carefully, then in the atmosphere, basically five spheres which are present. What are the five spheres? Please keep this thing in your mind, students. Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. So these are the five spheres which are present in the atmosphere basically. Okay, so remember this thing very carefully. Now students, you know that this stratosphere, it is getting damaged day by day just because of the this type of the emission which is coming out of through the different agencies. You know that, like you can see here in this picture, large scale emission of the smoke, it is coming from the factories, from the vehicle, from the burning of the coal, from the burning of the fossils, etc. So when we burn anything, a lot of fumes comes out, correct? From the factories as well, from the vehicle as well, there are many type of the smoke and the fumes also comes out. That smoke directly goes and mix into the air and it contaminates the whole air. And that contaminated air, we cannot breathe properly. Because the thing is that it will cause damage to our lungs as well. So when these kind of the smoke gets mixed into the air gets contaminated. And this condition of the air, we call it as what? Air pollution. What we call it as basically air pollution. So what is the meaning of air pollution, students over here? Remember the definition of the air pollution. Because in exam, as we discussed, answer in one sentence, answer in one word, true or false, filling the blanks, odd man out, any sort of questions might come, even true or false will come. Okay, so for that purpose, you have to remember, don't worry, there will be four options which will be provided to you, but still for that purpose also you have to be sure about the perfect option. So you can see that here the smokes of the different agency which are coming out, they directly goes and it directly mixes into the atmosphere. And this disturbs the balance between the constituent of the air, and this condition we call it as what? Air pollution. So during the air pollution, as you can see that the harmful gases are given out through the combustion of the fuel in the vehicle and the big industries, and most of the time incomplete combustion of the fuel like wood and the coal, this also releases harmful gases at the larger scale. So that's why these are the air pollution which are causing. So we have to stop the air pollution, otherwise we will contaminate the whole air. And do you know that, student, during the combustion process there are basically harmful gases which are coming out. So what are the harmful gases? Please remember this point. What are the harmful gases which are coming through the combustion of the fuel? Nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and soot. Repeat once again. Nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and soot. These are the harmful gases which are coming out of the burning of the fossil fuels as well as from the pollution as well. So remember this thing, because later on we are going to solve the certain objective depend upon this. So you know that, student, why these we have to worry about the air pollution? Because the reason is that, student, why we are worrying about the air pollution, because as you can see that here in the, student, on the stratosphere layer, below the stratosphere layer, you can see that over here ozone layer is present. And do you know that, student, ozone layer, it is protecting our body. from the sun, ultraviolet rays are directly coming on the earth. These ultraviolet rays, they are harmful for all type of the living thing which are present on the earth. And this ozone layer, it is protecting us. But do you know that because of the harmful gases which we are releasing right now, this ozone layer, it is getting destroyed. And suppose if ozone layer get destroyed, no, so ultraviolet rays, they will directly fall on the earth and the living thing which are present on the earth, they will get damaged soon. So that's why we have to protect ourselves in order to protect the ozone layer also. So if we protect the ozone layer, ultimately we will also get protected. So to make aware about the people about the importance of the ozone layer, each year 16th September worldwide we celebrate as the ozone protection day. Which day we celebrate as the ozone protection day? 16th September. Understood? So 16th September we celebrate as the ozone protection day, just to make aware people aware about the importance of the ozone layer. Got it, student? Why ozone layer is so much important to us? Because it is protecting us from the ultraviolet rays and it is protecting the life which is present on the earth. Understood now? And most importantly, the water which is present on the earth, it is protected, it is supplied to us through the water cycle. As you can see that over here in this diagram, student, see what happens basically, the water which is present in the sea and ocean, the water, it is getting evaporated in the form of water vapor, correct? The water which is present in the sea and ocean, it is getting evaporated in the form of water vapor, and this water vapor, they are going on the clouds. So when this water vapor get condensed, they fall as a rain back on the earth, correct? So you can see that over here, this water again, it is trapped inside the land. So again, this cycle will go on. So this cycle, it is occurring frequently on this earth. So this cycle, we call it as what? Water cycle. What we call it as? Water cycle. So because of the water cycle, we are getting the supply of the water naturally. So how it is happening? In the sea and water, the water, it is getting evaporated, the water vapor, it is getting condensed, and after condensation, the water vapor, it is falling as the rain. Understood now, student? So this is how the water cycle, it is operated in the nature. Shall we solve the questions now, depending upon whatever little bit revision we have done right now? Okay, read the question carefully, student. What has been asked to you? Which of the following is not harmful gas? Which of the following is not harmful gas? Not harmful gas, they had asked you. Pay attention here. Not harmful gas. So you have to read the question carefully. They had asked you not harmful gas. What is option A? Nitrogen dioxide. What is option B? Soot. What is option C? Carbon dioxide. What is option D? Oxygen. So just we have discussed now. This nitrogen dioxide, soot, carbon monoxide, they are coming out after the combustion of the coal and etc. So of course they are harmful. So which one is the safer one? Which one is the safer, which we usually use for the breathing purpose? So which is not harmful, which is useful in fact? Yes. So oxygen is a useful, which we use on for the breathing purpose. So correct option is the option D. So if you feel that out of ABCD option D is the correct option, so you will click on the option D like this. Understood, student? So like this in your exam also, you will be provided with the four option. So out of four option, you have to click on the right option. Now, again, there will be true or false kind of the question which will be there. And again, true or false, you don't have to type anything. You have to just click on the right option. Now, what is the question they had asked you, student? Read carefully. 19th September is celebrated as the ozone protection day. What they had asked you? 19th September is celebrated as the ozone protection day. Is it the 19th September which is celebrated as the ozone protection day? Just we have discussed now. Which day is celebrated as the ozone protection day? We had discussed right now. It is not 19th. What it should be? It has to be 16th September. 16th September it is celebrated as the ozone protection day. So the given statement, whatever they had provided to us, is it true or false, students? Yeah, of course it is false, whatever statement they had given us. So option A says it is true, option B says it is false. So according to our knowledge, it should be the 16th September, not the 19th September. So the B is the right option right now. So if you feel that the B is the right option, so you have to click on the B option like this. So automatically your answer will be selected. Understood now, students, what I am telling you here? Okay, so like this, for your exam you are supposed to click on the right option. So I hope so, student, you must be aware about the objective type of the question which will be asked for your exam. Okay, now let's see the next part of this topic. Let's revise once again. Now you know that, student, we had already discussed the soil formation in our previous session. So if you want to see the soil formation again, you can go back to our session and you can see how exactly the soil formation occurs. But as you know that the land is seen in the form of stone, soil, big rock, and the land is not flat everywhere, correct? So it's at some places the land is hilly and in some places it is flat also. So how exactly the soil formation takes place, student, you know that. Why land is so much important to everybody, student? Because as you know that all terrestrial animal including man, we live on the land. Some terrestrial animal like they dig the burrow in the ground for the shelter, correct? This means that they use the land for the fulfilling their need as well as, correct? And most importantly, you know that we use the land for the farming purpose. We use the land for the building of the houses and the road. We use the land for extraction of the mineral, crude oil, the natural gas which is obtaining from the earth. So all this purpose, the land is very important. And how soil formation occurs, you know that. So for the soil formation purpose, basically we should know the what land is made up of. We had already discussed all this thing. So as you can see that over here in this diagram, on the topmost layer, humus is there. Can you see the humus? Humus is the topmost layer. Which is the topmost layer? Humus. It is a soft soil which is supplying the nutrition to the plant. And at the bottom, what you can see here? Bedrock. At the bottom, it is bedrock. As the main rocks are there, you can see here. At the bottom, bedrock it is there. At the topmost, humus is there. So basically, you can see that the land, it is made up of soil, small stone, worms, insect, pieces of the bedrock, etc. So all these things comes together and they form of what? Land. So remember, what land is made up of? Soil, small stone, worm and the insect. Okay, and most importantly, how the humus formation occurred. Remember the definition of the humus, student. Remember the definition of the humus. The topmost layer of the soil is formed by the decomposition of dead plant and the animal. Decomposition of dead plants and the animal is called as what? Humus. Now what is the importance of the humus? Please learn the why humus is very important. It is very important for answer in one word, true or false, filling the blank, match the following, etc. So please learn all these points in detail. So why humus is important? Note down this in your notebook as well. Humus supplies nutrient to the soil. Secondly, it is important for aerating the soil. Thirdly, the humus is useful for holding up water in the soil because water is essential for the growth and development of the plant. Understood, student? So I hope so, whatever part we have covered till now. So here basically we completed the lesson number one, revision, natural resources, air, water and land. In the third session we will complete the nutrition and diet revision. Okay, so see you in the next session. All the best for your exam. Bye, take care.